Hello everybody, my name is Pravus, and welcome to my Twitch stream of Offworld Trading Company. We are going to be playing with the Blue Chip Ventures DLC today. This is something that was sent to me by the developers a couple of months ago, and I want to give them a big thank you for that. But I never really had a chance to look at it, in part because it is extremely challenging from what I can tell. And I was kind of hoping that the community would develop some guides and stuff I could refer to just so I could get kind of my feet under me. But so far that has not happened, so we're going to be going into this kind of blind, and hopefully we will do okay, although I am anticipating this is going to go horribly, I'm going to fail a lot, we're probably going to lose, but hey, let's take a look at the DLC. So if you guys don't know what this is going to be, here we go, Blue Chip Ventures, new DLC, was released back in February. If you click on this, what you can see is we have a whole bunch of different scenarios. Now think about something like Plague Inc., where you have a bunch of official scenarios that add little twists into the game to try and make it more challenging in some way. That's basically the sort of thing we've done here. What I understand the developers did is they contacted one of the top-ranked players, I think his name is Blue, and asked him to develop several different scenarios that they could code into the game. And he did, and the problem I find is that these are very challenging to match some of the higher-level players of Offworld Trading Company in the multiplayer scene, which is nowhere near my skill level, so we're gonna try it. We're probably gonna lose, but that's where this stuff comes from. First things we have is supply and demand, which has several different scenarios that are kind of geared around learning how to read a market, manage your materials, kind of see what are the, and kind of predict where the needs are gonna be of the market and stuff like that. Then you have some different scenarios to make your opponents kind of stack up against you and make things a little bit more difficult. Long-term planning, I'm not too sure about this one. This seems to be all late game focused stuff. I don't know, let's take a look at a couple of these real quick, just so you can see what I'm talking about. So in supply and demand, let's just say claim flexibility and shipping. Shipping long distances can be very costly, and claims used to gather resources from far away will be difficult to use for production later. So in other words, it's a scenario where they're greatly increasing the shipping costs, the fuel costs, and stuff like that. So you want to be building your base in a really tight-knit kind of area close by, but that may not always be an option. And then you have some things like yeah, for example, best served cold. Alarmed by your consistent success on Mars and by your ruthlessness, your opponents have joined together to beat you. So it's one person versus all the AI allied together. Stuff like that. Really difficult. I don't know why they say some of these are more challenging than others. I think they're all pretty challenging. That's my personal opinion. So let's just start at the very beginning, okay? I'm probably going to fail, but let's take a look at some of them. Reading markets. This is the first one in supply and demand. Let's click on this sucker. All players are going to start with a level 3 headquarters with a certain level of debt, but our competitors have already established all of their production while we have all of our claims still free to place. There are two major sources of demand, the colony and the players themselves, so clearly this scenario is geared to try and teach you how to read a market, how to predict where there are going to be shortages, and how to gain monopolies over certain resources so you can become wealthy and beat the game. How scarce and expensive additional claims can be, reading the markets will be the difference. Yeah, alright. So let's go ahead and start a new game of this, and we're gonna see what happens. Is the chat recorded too, Action Pack Dude? No, it is not. It's just the stuff on YouTube. So those of you who are in the Twitch stream, you can see the chat going on right now. The rest of you on YouTube, not so much. Alright. All players will start on HQ level 3. You have all the claims you normally would at that level, but they are not allocated yet. This is the only one of the scenarios that I have opened up and taken a look at so far. Make sure that we're paused so we can take a look. All right. So, you can see here that some of our opponents have already established themselves. We have a level 3 scavenger HQ over Mia. Level 3 expansive HQ here. A scientific HQ over here. And this is going to be me. I am already established as a level 3 expansive HQ right here. Now, if we take a look at the map, the goal, as they said, is to figure out where the needs of the market are going to be based on consumption, based on production. But at the same time, we still are only level 3 and we're going to need to start building ourselves up, right? So let's pay attention to all of that. First thing I notice here is that the colony, the Earth colony, does have several different habitats, which is normal. They're going to be consuming water, food, and oxygen, so I know that there's going to be consumption of those, and if no one's producing it, over time the stock prices will be going up. And it looks like we have a whole bunch of warehouses, so glass is going to be in high demand. That is what I would guess here. Yes, there is snow on Mars. Alright, so looks like our opponents are creating some chemicals. oxygen and fuel and carbon so far. Okay, it makes sense for a scavenger. Steel going up here. Food going here. Iron. Okay. More chemicals. Steel. More oxygen, more fuel. And some people are already mining out the aluminum and stuff like that. So what I'm noticing, first off, right, if I have to pick out where some shortages are going to be, I am noticing right away that there is no power. Nobody has built any power yet. That's going to be a shortage in the market. That might be a place that I can exploit, try to get some more money. I think that makes some sense. So we could try placing some wind turbines and stuff like that. Try to get as much power as possible. Alternatively, there are the solar panels. The problem with solar panels is you want to have as much sun access as possible, but once the sun sets, you get nothing. So what I'm looking at here is a solar panel that produces 1.1 power as long as the sun is up, so half of the day. But if we did wind turbines up here, these will run all the time, and I can probably fit a bit more up here. If I just did a simple trio of wind turbines, would that be better? By the way, if we have any expert off-world trading company players in chat, please speak up, because I will certainly be looking for help from the chat. So if you have ideas, let me know down there. Yeah, I think going for some power would make a little bit of sense. That is going to help pay off our debt. Hopefully the price is going to skyrocket and we can make some serious money. So I'm going to go ahead and place down two wind turbines. And if you don't know, in off-world trading company, of course there is an adjacency bonus when you put two things of the same type together. So that's going to be really important. It's one of the reasons I like looking at this trio right here. That's going to be pretty strong. Yeah, it looks like people are agreeing that the turbines are a good idea. Buy low, sell high. That is the idea, isn't it? All right, so what are the things that we're going to need? Well, we're going to need to get some steel and stuff. We certainly are going to want to upgrade to a level 4 HQ. That's going to need some aluminum, steel, and glass. So if we have some iron right here, I think the most obvious thing to do would be to construct a metal mine at least like that. That should produce 2 iron per second. Could also build a couple of steel mills. 2 of them, in fact, would consume all of that iron. So I could turn two iron per second into 1 steel, well, with an adjacency bonus. Now, I do like building my production buildings on top of the resource that they're associated with. The reason being, even though I'm not a scientific HQ, if for whatever reason the price of steel plummets and the price of iron goes high, I can easily demolish these and just get the iron instead and make a lot more money that way. So I think I'm going to go ahead and place 2 steel mills down here, and we'll get an adjacency bonus for that. Probably will need a little bit of water at the very least. And for water, that's going to be a little bit more tricky. So I do see 3 little bits of water down here. So some adjacency bonuses could be okay, but there is a bit of a distance to travel. The alternative is to place some solar condensers and start melting the snow using the sun. We can put those close by and don't have any need for fuel. 1.5 for half of the day. Solar condensers work the same as solar tiles. They can only work for half the day. As opposed to 1.5 adjacency stuff here, but they require fuel. Can the AI destroy your stuff? Yeah, there's a black market like anything else. They can definitely start blowing up things. Going heavy into aluminum. I only see the one grouping of it. I do see a lot of aluminum here, but there's another grouping over here, and it looks like the other AIs have already picked out their aluminum. Aluminum may be a little bit difficult for me to get in the early game, because I don't see a level 3 tile of aluminum anywhere. The best thing we might be able to do is grab this level 2. We are going to need at least 1. Let's go ahead and build that out. That will require some fuel. Do you guys think that water from pumps or solar condensers is going to be better? There is a lot of water up here, too. There's a lot more water up here, actually. But again, that's going to use up a bunch of claims. And it's going to require some fuel. Don't forget about getting a goon squad. Oh, absolutely. And there are off-world markets. So, well, or is it locked for good? No, yeah, there should be off-world markets. So goon squads are going to be very important for that. So how do you get glass? The way that you get glass here is going to be using an elemental quarry. And that is something we're probably going to want to do, since I know that the colony is going to be consuming a lot of glass. Glass is probably going to be in high demand. So what we can do then is place a couple of elemental quarries, pick up silicon, and then we'll need to build some glass kilns and those will be able to consume silicon and oxygen and turn it into glass. And it doesn't look like anybody right now actually is mining any silicon, now that I think about it. I don't see anyone mining silicon at all. So that's going to be pretty valuable for us. We definitely should take advantage of that. I'm definitely going to build at least one here. And if I can get adjacency up to my base, I won't be consuming any fuel. So we probably should place a couple of glass kilns. One, two, kind of like that. And we'll consume up some of the silicon using that way. Bugster3000 says go with the pump. A couple other people are saying some solar. Seems like a lot of people are thinking that solar might be the best way to go. I don't think Bugster is correct as far as the pump. Okay, he's right in one thing. So the EMP, if that thing goes off near my base, obviously that'll turn down off everything, including the solar condensers. Pumps can still be turned off with an EMP, I think, but he'd have to waste it all the way up here. That said, I mean, we're already kind of going up against the clock. I think we have to do the solar, honestly. We're going to do two solar for now. Did I already get some aluminum? Yes, I did get some aluminum. So let's go for two solar. Let's go for a little bit of food. And I think this is the best we're going to be able to do for the time being. So let's go ahead and try it out. Whoops. Why is it auto pause? I hit a hotkey. Never mind. Okay. So we're going to go with this for now. So we're going to have a bit of steel production, bit of iron production, some silicon turning into some glass. We're going to have a bit of water production so we don't go into too much debt. Food's already skyrocketing in price, so we're going to try to make some of our own.
The black market is online.
We have a bit of aluminum coming in, and perhaps most importantly, once our ships arrive, we will be constructing some wind turbines. And as I said, the price of power is already starting to skyrocket because nobody's producing it and everyone is consuming it. I think that actually is going to be really potent for us. Do we have the ability to get more claims? Cook the books, filthy pirates, EMP, core sample. No extra claims on the black market. Okay. Well, that's good to know. We probably will need to auto-supply our glass kilns. We aren't producing any oxygen right now, so they're going to have to get their own. We really want to upgrade to a level 4 and get more claims, so that's going to be a high priority for us. But the good news is, we will be producing the glass, steel, and aluminum that we need. And the power, I am hoping, will tide us over. Whoop. Someone used an EMP on the AI, so that's going to shut down their buildings for a little while. Less steel, less food.
HQ has been upgraded.
Silas Crichton, already upgraded to level 4? How dare you? Frickin' AI, I hate these guys. Is it always going to be in Mars, or are you going to expend other planets? I think you mean expand to other planets. It is always Mars with one exception. There was a DLC that added in, I think it was Ceres? An asteroid? The Ceres Initiative or something like that?
HQ has been upgraded.
So that is the one exception. You can go to the asteroid if you want to. I'm going to stock up some money. I'm not going to pay off my debt. Right now, nobody's buying anyone's stock, so I don't think that's going to be a super high priority, but we really want to start getting more steel and aluminum. We're actually already doing good on glass, and the price of glass is starting to go up. So if I need to, I can start selling off some glass and get a little extra cash. That's going to be good. Do we want to get anything else here? Goon squads, mutiny, underground nuke, core sample, pirates. Pirates could be good depending on where the shipping lanes are, but I'm not seeing a whole lot from my opponents. There's a bit going on over here, I suppose, for water and aluminum and stuff, but that's about it. I don't think going for pirates right now is good. It does increase in cost as time goes on. Yeah, food is on the rise due to the size of the colony.
Oh,
they're building pleasure domes. All right. Notice the price of power, though. Look at this stuff going up, 140. Yeah, that's going to work out really well if my AI opponents do not build any power sources. And building was disabled. He disabled my power. All right, fine. Screw you, too. Good news is the price of water has mysteriously plummeted. Somebody just offloaded all of their water. Let's go ahead and sell off a bit of... Whoops. Oh, shoot. Didn't want to do that. Sell off a bit of glass. Make a few thousand extra dollars. So we still need to get $15,000 to buy enough aluminum and steel to beat this. What else should I sell? A little excess silicon, perhaps? I have plenty of water, but it's worthless to me now. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to scrap the solar condenser, and I'm going to replace it with a farm. We're doing fine on water right now. Water's worth nothing, but food is worth a ton. So let's switch up that claim. Nuke the food. North of the map. What, this stuff? I don't... nuking this stuff won't really do anything. So the way the underground nukes work is if you find a tile of, let's say, this two water right here, you place a nuke, it's going to destroy the resource to, like, a scarcity. And it's a good way of screwing over somebody's claim, but I don't think it does much of anything on a farm where it doesn't have anything underneath it. So, for example, this high aluminum right here, it could be worth screwing them over. Purchase a nuke, use. Boom! And just like that, it's now down to a low-density aluminum deposit. Alright. Still need more money. Sell off some of the glass. We can upgrade! There we go. Alright, 5 more claims to work with. So what should we do with these now? We are at least producing more food than we're consuming. So that at least is not going to come back to bite me. Are these guys still shut down? Unfortunately, they are. Price of power is still going up. I see one person built a turbine over here. What are you building? A patent lab. People are going for science. More patent labs. Anyone else producing power, though? There's one more wind turbine over here. I think we could go... we could justify going for even more wind, I think. How much money do we need for this? 7.5k? Oh, the price of carbon's quite high. Yeah, that'll do it. What do you guys think? Finish the wind turbine triforce? Can you disable the food? Yeah, if you use an EMP, you could shut that down. Of course, if I do that and we're producing less food, it's going to increase the cost of food too. So, more power and food, maybe a special building as well is what people are recommending. Alright.
Pirates. I hate those filthy bandits.
I love the AI when it says that. I hate those filthy bandits.
A new claim is available.
New claim. We will bid on this sucker. I'll go up to about 10,000-ish. Okay, we're going to take on some debt. We're going to get an extra claim. Nope, someone else is taking it. Alright. Anastasia, if you want to take on that extra debt, that's fine with me. Nope, Mikhail. Alright, we're just going to have to wait for this. Are you going to play multiplayer later? Probably not.
Sold.
I'm just trying to get through as many of these scenarios as we can and kind of learn about how this stuff works. I'm expecting it to go terribly. Alright, let's get another wind turbine, and by having 3 here, we're going to increase the efficiency of all of them. So that's going to be a lot of extra power at $232 per second. That's going to be a lot of money. A lot of money. People are saying we could go for more food. Now, if we do that, we are now consuming more water than we're producing. Water's still really cheap, though, so that might be okay. We'll place another farm here. Price of glass is going way up. I'm kind of wondering if we want to focus more on that. Alternatively, we could go for a bit more water and try to get some oxygen and fuel production so that those don't come back to bite us. So if you guys don't know what all the icons are, I'm seeing some people asking a bit of questions about this game and stuff they don't know. So this is power. We have water, food, oxygen, fuel, aluminum, or aluminium, depending on where you're from, iron, steel, carbon, silicon, chemicals, glass, and electronics. The goal of the game is to buy out all of your opponents in a hostile takeover. Buy all their stock, become a majority shareholder. So we need a lot of money in order to make that work, and I want to outcompete everybody as far as the market is concerned. Now, I'm looking at the price of food starting to collapse a little bit, and that makes me a little nervous. Price of water is going up. We have 3 claims left. Yeah, the price of food might be about to go down. If so, though, I can always just repurpose one of these claims. So I'm going to go ahead and build another solar condenser. I'm also going to build at least one electrolysis reactor. And the price of silicon is still so much lower than glass, I'm kind of thinking we go for another glass kiln. Because that's one thing we know the colony is consuming a lot of. The alternative is to build a special building, but I think I might wait until HQ level 5 for that. So let's increase the efficiency of our glass kilns. See if that works. Oop. People are buying some shares. Cold fusion acquired. Ugh. Alright, so that person can just turn water into power now. Wow, price of water is starting to skyrocket. What the crud is happening there? It's a good thing we're producing some.
The black market is open.
Go ahead and sell off some of this food as the price is starting to collapse. But again, if the price of food goes so far down that it's no longer profitable, I can just turn this into another condenser. Black market is online. Is there anything we want to do with this? Could use an EMP. Wouldn't mind shutting down some of these pleasure domes and stuff. could screw over this guy's food and try to make the price of food go up again. Also try to shut down his... Well, we can't quite shut down his power at the same time. But the price of steel and stuff is quite high. This guy's going to get screwed over if we do this. EMP!
A scientific HQ has been upgraded.
Silas is already up to level 5. I hate scientific. Those guys are so freaking powerful. Oh, screw that. We're out of money. Alright, hang on. Sell off some glass, buy some oxygen. And... we should now be producing some fuel and some oxygen as well. Okay. New mic? No, it's the same mic. It's just, unfortunately, I don't have a good equalizer software, so I don't do the kind of the audio processing I would do on YouTube. We're making a fair good amount of aluminum right now. Actually, I shouldn't have sold that just now. That was a mistake. Why did I do that? I was thinking I was already on HQ level 5, but I'm not. So we need a bit more glass, steel, and aluminum to upgrade. I can, however, sell some of this food, and yes, the price is plummeting. The price of water is going way up. All right, let's demolish this sucker and put in another solar condenser, and we can just trade off as much as we need to. And now someone's selling all the water. Come on! Price is holding steady at $240 for power right now, though. We're getting that pretty consistently, so that's $800 a second. We're paying off our debt really quickly. Long term, I think we might be okay. Price of glass is going up. I can afford to sell a little bit of this. Make a bit of cash. Anything else we want to do here? Cook the books. No, I don't want to improve my bond rate. Could we use pirates? Have these guys developed anything really useful? Not seeing anything right now. No really strong traffic lanes, you know? You don't know how that works. You set up a filthy pirate, and anything that kind of comes through it is going to get shot down, and we're going to steal some of their resources. But most of the things are pretty spread out. We're not going to get much. Carbon and aluminum if we did this here. But the price of carbon and aluminum is quite low right now. Price of steel, you can see, has plummeted lately. It's really oxygen that we need. Let's auto-purchase some water. Apparently we're not getting enough. And that's because the solar condensers aren't active during night. There we go. There we go. That turns things on. Okay. Well, we're not consuming a lot more oxygen. Maybe mutiny his power. Could. I'm watching the price of power go down now, which means we're overproducing somewhere. Might be better just to shut off a wind turbine. Try to keep the price of power high. It also would be really good to shut down a patent lab, though. Try and make sure that... they don't get too many good techs. Mikhail scares me. He's been purchasing a lot of shares of himself, and everyone's trying to buy him out right now. Good news is my share price is quite high, so I'm not a prime target right now. We can upgrade. All right, 6 more claims. Now comes the point where we really have to buckle down on a strategy. Price of glass is still remarkably high. We could build electronics. It's not predicting that this will get me very much money, though. Partly because look at the price of silicon. I think we need to get more silicon. We're producing not enough of that. That's worth a lot. We can get an adjacency bonus. Let's do it. So that's one claim. Should we get ourselves a special building? Hacker arrays to try and manipulate the markets. Pleasure Dome to try and just get straight up money. Patent Lab if we want to get some tech. We could do that. It'd be pretty costly, but we could get some really useful tech if we do this. But what would we want to get? That's the question. I don't think we can take a look at what... Oh, yeah, here you can. All right. Let's take a look at the patents. What do we have available? Financial instruments to get money off of their debt. Right now, the AIs are in a pretty reasonable amount of debt. We can make a lot of money doing that. Water engine. So we don't have to use any fuel anymore. That's only useful if the price of water is much lower than fuel. Virtual reality, no. Nanotechnology, no. Carbon scrubbing, slant drilling, thinking machines, teleportation is not that helpful. So if I did build a patent lab, the only thing I think I really would care about is financial instruments. Because I can get a lot of money off of their debt if I do think something like that. But that's it. I don't know if it's quite worth that level of effort. We get a quick update on what? Hang on, sorry. Actually, we can't see the share prices except... Oh, I'm so sorry. I totally forgot on OBS. One second that I kept my face here. There we go. Sorry about that. All right. I meant to do that. Totally forgot. I think we need to get some more oxygen. So let's go ahead and do that. We're still producing an absolute ton of water. So I'm going to build another one here with the anticipation that I can scrap it later if I need to. Silicon we already have coming in. I think we double down a bit more on some glass. And I'm not going to double down on power because the price is going down right now. Sell off some of the glass. Let's get patent lab. Let's just do it. Let's try it. I'm going to go for this. Once that's built, we should also go for an off-world market. Those are really good, but we need electronics. I think I want to save at least one claim for an off-world market. Could be really good. Auction starts in 7 seconds. I'm not sure what they're going to auction yet, but... looks like we have a surplus of oxygen, which is killing the price of that right now. A land tile. Which tile? This tile right next to the colony? I'll bid on it. We could get a pleasure dome with that. I'll bid. I have no debt, so... Alright, I'm not sure I'm willing to go into that much extra debt for it. Yeah, no. Let's not worry about that.
Congratulations. Okay.
So we have our patent lab coming in. That's getting built. Electrolysis reactor should be coming online. We lost control of one of our wind turbines, but it's only one of them. I'm looking at that silicon and I'm thinking, holy crap, that's worth a ton of money. Price of power is starting to go way down. I can't rely more on power. I don't want to rely on oxygen. I really think it comes down to the glass. The glass is worth an absolute ton of money. A pleasure dome would get me what? About $150 or so. It's not that important. Chemicals, not that important. Fuel prices are going up. We're not consuming too much oxygen anymore. We are overproducing water right now. I think electronics could make some sense, but... I'm not going to get a lot of profit off of that is the problem. What do you guys think? Everyone's still saying things like oxygen and stuff. Answering a couple other questions that are unrelated to the game, though. As far as EU4 is concerned, I probably will be playing a Japanese daimyo. Just guessing. We'll try to seize the Celestial Throne. And as far as Monks and Mystics, I actually would like to do a stream on that relatively soon. Price of glass is still going up. Gosh dang it. Build another one! I'm going to save my last claim for an off-world market, though. Do we want to do an EMP or something and try to steal somebody's patent lab? Or at least shut it down? I would like to do that. I'm going to do an EMP on this guy right here. I'm going to shut things down for him. He's got a bunch of important buildings that are going to get shut down. He's going to be hurting pretty hard there. Okay. Sell off some of this glass. There we go. Off-world market. Place here. The patent lab is done. Oh, shoot. Someone already bought financial instruments. Crap. What else could we use? Nanotechnology can be useful. We don't need teleportation. We probably don't need... Well, water engine... Water engine could be good. That would make it a lot easier to operate our off-world market. That could save us some money. Let's go ahead and start researching that now. So do I think that expanding into chemicals or electronics could be profitable? It could be. Let's take a look. So right now it's predicting a reasonable amount of revenue for chemicals. It requires fuel and carbon to make that stuff. Here's the thing. I think that most of the technology that the AI is going to want is already done, at which point there's no real use for chemicals. So there's no point in producing it because no one's going to be consuming it and the colony is not consuming it. As far as electronics, this one might get useful. It really might. We could build at least one of them. At least it would give us another use for our aluminum, right?
A scavenger HQ has been upgraded.
Someone's got up to level 5. He's a little late. We're actually ahead of the curve right now. I don't know. I think as soon as we're done with the patent lab, then maybe we go for at least one electronics factory. What we need to be doing right now is saving up some money to spend on buying shares. And right now, I'm looking at these solar condensers, and I'm thinking the price of water's gone so low, I'm going to go ahead and demolish this. And I'm actually going to place another electrolysis reactor. I know it doesn't have an adjacency bonus, but we're going to get a lot more money out of that. There's a lot of profit to be had here. Go Electronics and Offworld Market. That's where we make the most money with capital. Yeah. Normally, our food gonna get really expensive into the game. Usually by the late game, a lot of people are producing food, so... But this is the laws of supply and demand, right? If there's a lot of demand and the supply meets that, then the price is gonna stay pretty steady. If you oversupply more than you are consuming, then the price is gonna go down, and vice versa if you are not producing enough. So the goal of this entire scenario is to try and watch that, figure out what is needed and what is not. All right, water engine has been acquired. Good, that means we can operate our off-world market remarkably cheaply. Now, is there anything else we really want to get? Nanotechnology is good, but is it worth $8,000? Carbon scrubbing could save us a bit of money, but the price of carbon's really low. I don't think so. I think we're gonna get rid of our patent lab. I don't think we need it anymore. Demolish that. Okay. And what we want to get next, I think we said an electronics factory could be good. Looking to see what else is profitable. Silicon is still very profitable. Still the electrolysis reactors. That's where I'm making a ton of money. It's more profitable to do this. Let's go ahead and make use of our electrolysis reactors and try to make it stronger. Now let's go to the off-world market and see what the prices are. So there's a ton of profit to be made right now from launching food. Okay. That's pretty good. We could do that. Lost control of another wind turbine. Well, the price is starting to go up. Would love to get a goon squad to protect my off-world market if I could. Let's sell off a lot of our glass, because we don't need this much. We're going to try to send off... We need 100 food to do this, but it's worth even buying the food to send it out. The alternative is oxygen, which is worth a lot as well. Chemicals is worth a surprising amount. I think we go ahead and do the food. Let's launch some food out into space, make some money. I need to start buying shares in people, though. Let's buy some shares in Anastasia. Yeah, power price just jumped up. Yeah, say goodbye to the water price. Water's pretty cheap right now. Dirt cheap, in fact. There's honestly no point even having these solar condensers. Demolish that. Another electrolysis reactor. Demolish that. Food. We can sell food for a crap ton of money. Off-world. Of course, now the price is starting to go back up. That just sort of figures. Everyone is stealing stuff, and now we have lost our off-world market. Because I didn't get a goon squad. Okay, is there anything else we want to shut down to drive some patent prices up? We could try to really spike the price of oxygen and fuel. That would screw people over a little bit. Food. I'm gonna do another EMP right here. Shut down their power, shut down their food, shut down their patent lab. That's gonna hurt Anastasia a lot. That way we can start spending some of our money to buy out her shares. We're gonna try to buy her out first, I think. Buy more shares, sell off the silicon. Sell off a bit of fuel. Buy more shares. Okay. We're getting really close. We're going to have to buy her out. She's managed to buy most of her own shares of stock. So it's going to cost a lot of money in order to buy her out, but it's doable. I don't care about that aluminum. Sell off some of that. Keep our food because we're going to send that. I really am not appreciating that you stole my market. As you know, I kind of wanted to send some food out there, but all right. Do we purchase pirates? An optimization center. I'll bid on it. Don't think we're gonna get it, though. And I'm okay with him taking on some debt. I don't think I want it that much. Filthy pirates. Where could we screw these people over? Stealing water is about it. you are making some silicon. Silicon's worth a fair bit. And aluminum. Aluminum's worth nothing. That's the problem. What do we have here? This is a level 2 elemental quarry. This is a level 2 elemental quarry. We could just steal that and that'd be fine. I would rather steal things from Silas, I think. So let's place the pirates there.
I hate those filthy bandits.
Okay. Yeah, the power price is really going up. I know. That debt's a problem. The problem is that we're not producing any power because people are mutinying me. and stealing all the stuff that I'm making, so I'm going into debt now. But we'll be okay. The goal is just to buy these guys out. I'm going to buy some more stock in Anastasia. In order to finish her off, we need $248,000. Yeah, that's a lot of money. Still have some of that fuel. Price of food's starting to go back up. Price of water's starting to go back up. Steel is worth a fair bit. An underground nuke was used where? On one of my elemental quarries. All right, screw you two. Selling more stuff off. We buy some shares in other people. Someone's buying shares of my stock, huh? Yeah, I don't think that's going to go too well for you.
Is open for business.
Okay. Did we get control of our... No, it's still being mutinied. All right. I'm going to save this goon squad to protect this thing, because they're going to want to steal that every chance they get. I know that to be true. Now we're not producing nearly enough silicon. Unfortunately. But the price is going down. Going for glass does seem to have been a pretty decent tactic. Price of water is starting to skyrocket. Price of fuel and stuff is going down. Another nuke? More silicon. Alright, that's not very nice. You guys are being mean. Demolish this. Get a solar condenser. We need more water. Is this the blue chip DLC? Yes, it is. And unfortunately, despite the fact that this DLC has been out for a while, this is scary. Despite the fact that the DLC has been out for a while, nobody's really been able to create any guides for it. So, it appears the community has been having a lot of trouble. I'm going to go ahead and buy some of my own shares. He's threatening to buy me out right now, which I'm really worried about. Buy my own shares. Slow him down. Come on, we need daytime. I got too much solar stuff. Off-world market. What do we want to sell? We don't have any food. But that's where the most profit is. Place the goon squad on the off-world market. Now we're going to try to send in food again. Okay.
The black market is online.
The AI is fighting pretty hard. Another off-world market could be good, honestly. I'm mostly worried that the price of water is going way, way up. I'm going to go ahead and demolish this and build another solar condenser. And we cannot auto-supply these things right now because I don't have any cash. Aha! We intercepted your mutiny! Anastasia, you fool! I shall mutiny? Well, I'm a little bit worried about placing the mutiny on their off-world market because they're probably going to use it. They'll probably have a goon squad there. Let's try it. Hey! We got an off-world market! Alright, alright, alright. Let's send off some more food. Yay! To thunderous applause. Use the off-world market. Send out the money. Look at all of the money. Price of food is skyrocketing right now. But at least we're producing enough water that we're not in trouble. The price of power is gone. Just sad, really.
Off-world shipment launched.
Good.
Look at all the money.
Yes, look at all the money. So much money. I think we just keep launching food, honestly. First rocket is away! Thank you! Okay. Steel's still been pretty profitable for me, but now we have a surplus of glass, which means the price of this stuff's going way down. We're losing money on this. It'd be better probably to get some more elemental quarries. So what I can do is shut this guy down and activate another elemental quarry here. Get some adjacency bonuses on what little I have. This is one of the reasons we built our glass kilns on the silicon, so that I'll be able to switch this around if we had to. I still really want to buy out Anastasia. Really would like to do that. Are we not producing any glass anymore? Yeah, I'll build on the Pleasure Dome. I'll bid on that. Silas, you want to take on some more debt? Go for it. Anastasia, please take on that debt. Ah, I'm going to let them fight over it. Chemical buildings, the price is pretty good. There's actually a lot of... There is a lot of revenue to be made there. Only problem is I don't have any claims. I'd have to shut down a lot of stuff. Carbon scrubbing still exists. I'm going to go ahead and try this. You never know. I mean, well, no. Price of carbon's nothing. It's not worth it.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Silas, for taking on $28,000 of debt. I have the highest share price right now. If I can just make some money and buy out Anastasia, I'll be in really good shape. That's what I'm aiming for.
Launch affirmative. What a payout.
What a payout. Thank you. Okay, we're making a little bit of money still off of our power. Electronics. Yeah, electronics. I've been noticing that. Electronics have skyrocketed. Kind of tempting. What if we took away our glass kilns and started doing some electronics? Price of silicon has plummeted, though. The market's shifting so rapidly, I'm having a hard time keeping up.
Successful off-world shipment. Make room for the profits.
Alright, still need 350,000. Alright, let's try some more. Most profitable is going to be food still. Let's go ahead and send that out. Yeah, I think we need to switch our industry around here, guys. Electronics is really profitable. Chemicals have become outrageously profitable, which I don't understand. Almost all the tech has been researched. There's not really anything else to do with chemicals, but they're still doing it. But what would I get rid of? What would I get rid of? I guess more glass. I don't need glass. The glass prices have just plummeted completely. All right. Switch this around. Get rid of the glass kilns. Chemicals are more profitable. Build, build, build. We're gonna switch up our industry. The resolution of the video fell? Probably is your buffering stuff, I'm gonna guess. Goon Squad, my off-world. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Let's go ahead and do that. We do not want to lose our off-world market. Thank you. Thank you for the reminder. And now the price of chemicals is going to plummet? Come on! Don't do me dirty like this. That's just rude. All right. Purchase what we need. Make chemicals. The only thing we're having trouble with is water right now, and that's because water's doing really well. Price of chemicals is going way down. Way down. Carbon's worth a lot right now. Steel's worth a lot. Good thing I still have some of that industry going. Water and power. Alright. We're about to ship off some more stuff, at least. Gosh dang it, another nuke. Why would you do that to me? You destroyed my iron.
Off-world shipment launched.
I can buy this person out. The problem is, if I do that, I'm a little worried that I'm going to give enough money to Silas that he can buy me out, which is not good. I can't do it. I have to buy some of my own stock first. That'll save me, at least. By getting half of your shares, you make it so it's very difficult for them to buy you out. I think we need to go ahead and buy out Mikhail. Done. We own him. That's two more claims for me. What should we do with it? What do you guys think? Sell off some of our excess. Can't afford another off-world market right now, unfortunately. Too expensive. Glass is not profitable right now. Silicon prices are going back up. Let's go ahead and demolish this. Elemental quarry that thing. Price of carbon. Do we have carbon on the map? Yes, but it's a long ways away. Would have been nice to have had carbon scrubber, wouldn't it? But Silas bought it out, so. Everyone's saying electronics is the way to go. All right. Let's build out some electronics then. One, two. Purchase some iron. We're not getting enough steel. Look at that carbon prices, though. Oh my god. Electronics aren't going to stay very profitable for long. They're already going down. Just because this has a high number does not mean that it's the best thing to build. Keep in mind, this consumes carbon and the price of carbon is skyrocketing.
The black market is open for business.
Why are we not... Oh, crap. Our glass kilns are automatically turning themselves off because we're not making any profit on that. And now we're not making any profit on chemicals. Come on, people! The only thing that is profitable right now is water. So if chemicals are going to be this bad, then I think we need to demolish these now. I really wish I had the nanotechnology tech now. We'd be able to switch things around much faster. Okay, get some water. Switch the industry again. Price of silicon is still going up. I'm really worried about that carbon price, though. Now we're losing money on electronics, and they're automatically going to turn themselves off, so... Well, maybe they won't. No, see, this is where it gets confusing. It says here net revenue is minus 16, but if you hover your mouse over here, it says net is 27. If that's the case, then stuff like food is actually quite profitable for us. Glass is not, though. Making a lot of money on silicon. Gonna demolish this as well. Another elemental quarry. Sell a bit off. Sell these chemicals before the price goes much further down. We need to send off another off-world market. Food is still the most profitable, so that's what we're going to do. Now, with Mikhail bought out, we should be getting everything he's producing as well. We're actually overproducing power a lot. That's sort of my problem. Plenty of oxygen and stuff coming in, plenty of fuel. This is a really tough challenge so far, and I really think it comes down to the fact that we don't have any carbon. Not that we can get any now, but we may want to mutiny something. Who's producing carbon? You're producing carbon. Can I mutiny my own guys? How much carbon are we consuming? 0.5. So 1.5, right? Or just 1? Yeah, I don't think we're getting any of his carbon for some reason. Oh, come on! My own company... Goon squatted by carbon. Ah, that sucks. All right. We have the best stock price, though. They're not getting that close to buying me out. It'll give us a warning when someone's getting really close. I mean, they're getting a lot of shares here, but... So the thing is, if you buy your own shares, in order to buy you out, they have to pay you double what the cost is of these shares. We could buy some more to make sure that we're okay. And let's just go ahead and do that, but it's going to be incredibly difficult to buy me out. Stop using nukes! Damn these people! Alright, electronics can go. Silicon we can sell. Steel we can sell. Producing way more water than we need to because the price of water has plummeted again. Alright. Alright! Food! Food it shall be. I'm not really liking this scenario so far. This is proving a little bit tough. The net revenue from the build menu doesn't account for adjacency bonuses. That is true. That would explain why it's not working the way it's supposed to. I don't think having this electrolysis makes sense. I think more efficiency for my food makes a lot more sense. We're going to overproduce like crazy on food, but I think it's worth it. Price of silicon has gone down, and we did intercept a free EMP. Now, the person I'm the most worried about here is Silas. I would love to EMP so you lose your off-world market and most of your chemicals. His off-world market's right here, so if I did this, this would knock him out. And then some. EMP! There, have fun with that. Shortage of power. Oh my god, the power! Look at that! Look at the price of power! Down to 3! Oh no! I was anticipating power to last a lot longer than that. Alright, so electronics are really profitable. Food is really profitable. Electrolysis is pretty good. Silicon, not so much. What a payout. Sell off some. Ooh, price of oxygen's gone up there. Alright, let's sell some oxygen to Earth. So what we could do then is find something that's really unprofitable and just build another off-world market, and I think we need to do that. Demolish. Off-world. Demolish. Can't get another one yet. Hang on. Sell. Sell, 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 sell. I want more off-world markets. Come on. Well, I shouldn't be selling my electronics. We need electronics. Duh. All right. Price of water's going back up. Get rid of the silicon. We're doubling down on this whole food thing. Food is profitable. Food is money. Food is life. Be worried about Silas. The name drips with evil. It definitely does, doesn't it? Gosh dang, the price, though. Hey, wait a minute. Oh. Right, we can't build more off-world markets. For some reason I had it in my head, you can build 2 off-world markets per level 5 HQ. And because we own Mikhail, we should be able to get more. And yet, for whatever reason, it's not letting me do that. So do we go for even more food? Do we go for more water? Price of water is going up pretty hard. Go for more water. 2 off-world markets will make things a lot easier for us. It will. We're selling a heck of a lot more stuff off. Price of glass, it still says, is unprofitable. Electronics, though, is doing really, really well. Get rid of this and place another electronics factory, and let's get some more efficiency bonuses going on. It's all about managing that efficiency right now. That's what's going to be important. We can buy some stocks in Silas, or we can try to work toward enough money to buy out Anastasia. 477,000. That is cray-cray. More food! And another off-world market's done. Let's sell some oxygen. Let's get another goon squad up on this market.
Pirates.
Sell the electronics. Sell the steel. Okay. Price of food is starting to plummet. Probably because we're overproducing like crazy. Aha! Anastasia, you fool! Of course, you used up my goon squad, but... We can really mess up the price of power if we use it here. And I'm going to. There we go. Sorry, not the price of power. The price of food. So now she's not producing any food, which I would imagine means that the price of food should start going up. Become Rapture Farms and start selling something new and tasty. You know, I love an Oddworld reference. I do not see enough of those these days. Well done. You get a trophy. Electronics. Holy crap, though. All right, get rid of that. More electronics. More electronics. I don't think we can keep affording more goon squads, though. 110,000, it's a lot of money. Sell off some food. Just keep selling what we got. Really want to buy out Anastasia. You have no idea how much I want to buy out Anastasia. Off-world shipments going off! Look at all the money! And more food. There you go. Send out those rockets. 345,000. We actually still might beat the scenario. It's been one heck of a time. I get a trophy for recognizing it. Dude, I loved Oddworld stuff when I was a kid. Abe and Munch and all that stuff. Munch's Odyssey on the original Xbox. I had a heck of a time with that. It's been a long time. Solar flare. So basically, solar panels and solar condensers are now worth an absolute crap ton. Price of power is still worth nothing. You know what we could do if we wanted to is actually demolish our wind turbines and start building more stuff here. And that wouldn't even be that bad because we have water engines, so we don't even have to consume fuel shipping, just water. You know what? Screw the power. Screw it! Most money to be made. Actually, glass has gone way back up. Kind of figures, doesn't it? Do we want to build glass again? Yeah, let's build some glass again. We're going to build some kilns! It's going to take a long time to ship everything, but you know what? That's where the money is. We follow the money. It's how the game works. Getting... Oh, God, our freaking prices!
I hate those filthy bandits.
A couple more off-world shipments and we can buy someone off. She just needs some more debt. That's what we need to do. We need to have her get some debt. Buying out Red doesn't affect his company or resource income in any way. What did happen is the Red sells all his production constantly and a percentage of Red's cash is paid out every second, divided according to how the shares are split. Buy out Anastasia. Okay, my stock price just went up to 90. We have 2 more claims that we can work with. All right, good. So 2 more claims. What's worth it? Electronics are really still quite good. Food's gone down a bit. Not oxygen. Water's going up. Can we get another market? Because this is what I don't understand, is the whole HQ thing. I remember reading somewhere that if you had bought out somebody else's HQs, you could get more off-world markets. But I don't think that's actually the case in this. So I think we get some more electronics here. And the price of carbon's gone down. Are we expecting the price of silicon to go up much? We could get more steel. But electronics is still the way to go. Screw it. More electronics. Do it. Darth, if you have something you want to say that's not going to get caught by Nightbot, I'm prepared to listen. But if I'm doing something wrong that's upsetting you, sorry, not much I can do about it right now. Okay. Buy some shares in Silas Crichton. We need $540,000 in order to buy him out. And I think we got a very good chance of doing that. Price of power is going up, of course. Right after I sell this stuff, Alf! Come on! Oh, wait, off-road markets. Let us do this, and this is probably what Darth was screaming at me about, actually, and that makes sense now. There goes the aluminum. Joke's on you, I didn't care about that anyway. Could do a core sample, but I don't think it's worth the money. Electronics will be dropping shortly. Price of carbon's going up. Price of silicon, holy freaking faholies! Solar condensers. Go away! Elemental quarries! A-okay! Well, these trace amounts aren't worth much, but they'll at least give me some more efficiency bonuses. Yeah, the price of electronics is going down pretty fast, and that's because I'm overproducing, but... Got a lot of debt. I don't care about debt, I care about buying this guy out. Food is just gone. Food is garbage now. It's all about the electrolysis, so let's get a couple more of those going. Really wish I had gotten nanotechnology, because that would allow me to convert this stuff very rapidly. Yeah, electronics is almost not going to be profitable now. Almost. Not quite, but almost. Price of steel's going up. Could switch back to some glass. Glass is looking pretty good. Of course, that consumes more silicon, which we don't have. Freaking nukes. And there goes even more silicon. All right, so silicon's going to be a problem for a while, apparently. There goes this. The reason I'm not setting this to auto right now is because I want to reevaluate every time there's a cycle, make sure I'm getting the most profitable stuff. Put money in oxygen and ship it off-world. Power is falling again. Yes, it is. Oh, Darth was cheering, not screaming at me. Okay. Sorry for assuming the worst. It's part of my personality. This is proving to be a very long and intense game here. I think we're doing well, but... So food has become officially unprofitable now. So we need to switch tech to something else. Really wish we had some more aluminum available to us, because there's a ton of money to be made there. Not much money in electrolysis right now. Still money in electronics. It's all about the silicon, which I can't get. And now it's about water again. Okay. Okay, fine. Switch this up. Doop. Aren't we supposed to be producing glass? Where are my shipments of glass? Hey. No, hang on. Seriously, though. We're supposed to be producing a bunch of glass. We're shipping silicon off to them right now. That's why they haven't worked yet. Got a lot of debt coming in. Still need $590,000 to buy this guy out. It's all about these off-world shipping companies right now. That's all that matters. Just running out the clock. And an EMP certainly doesn't help anything. All right. You want to play that way? Fine. EMP, you too! There we go. Off-world markets. Can't do anything because it's EMP'd. But this one, fortunately, did not get caught in the blast.
Off-world shipment launched.
There you go. Get all the money. Do we have anything that will increase their production? No, we don't have, like, STEM stuff. Interestingly, we are about to ship off another
launch
shipment.
Affirmative. What a payout.
What the heck happened there? How'd we ship that off instantly? Does anyone know? We're really close to winning this right now. We just need a bit more money. Just a bit more money. Yeah, we have a lot of debt. I'll pay it off before the end of the night. That way we don't take on a bunch of extra... he's getting kind of close to buying me out, but I'm really close to buying him out. It may not be worth paying off my debt. That's money I can use to buy him out. We just need to get another couple more shipments out. Send off the oxygen. That EMP was really well timed on his part. Yeah, I'm not going to pay off my debt. We're getting really close to buying him out. I just need another good shipment. One or two more shipments and we're out of it. This is the home stretch. Home stretch.
Pirates. I hate those filthy
solar flares. All right, that's a lot of extra water. There we go. Bam! That's it. All right, we beat our first blue chip venture. Oh, God. Oh, God. All right. I know, some people are saying, pay off your debt, stop, you know, demolishing all your stuff and building everything. Yeah, I understand. Frustrating, but I'm trying to change the markets, because as you notice throughout this game, the markets were shifting rapidly throughout. You have to be able to adapt. I know you want to reach a certain level of balance and be sustainable, but sometimes those prices, you know, aren't going to stay there forever, and you want to capitalize on it as long as you can. That's one of the reasons nanotechnology is such a good tech. I love that. But there, we got it. And the reason I didn't pay off my debt is because if I spent off $95,000, you know, that would have taken me longer to buy out my opponents. At this point, it's like sacrificing your queen to go for checkmate. That's the reason I did that. So I know the debt was painful for people. I was watching chat, but it worked. We won as a result. I received a lot of nasty sabotage. But we did it. We beat our first one. All right, let's exit this and move on. Oh, gosh. Reading markets is really, really tough. I mean, the reason people go into it first is because it's the first one on the list. Thank you for another donation, Push and Pain. Really appreciate that. Is that as a reward for doing well? And by doing well, I mean I was passable. I beat it. All right, so what do you guys think is a good one next time? We can move on more supply and demand. We can move on to exploiting a monopoly to get an advantage. That would be really interesting, learning how to do that. The alternative is stock battles. One of your opponents is heavily invested in your stock. Find a way to beat them and two other opponents. Yeesh, that's scary. Debt management. Debt is your friend, but can spiral out of control quickly. What do you guys think is good? Stock battles. I'm seeing some of that from Darth. All right. Anybody else? All right. Geeky Meerkat says, my experience with Pravus since I learned about him on YouTube. He killed everyone that didn't follow him on YouTube with a plague. Then he established an O2 monopoly on the people that survive. I'm afraid to look at what type of government he's actually running. I assume dictatorship. Probably. Debt? Looking for some suggestions here, guys. What do you want to see? Continue with the supply and demand and make it more difficult, or play well with others? Stock battles? Whatever you guys want to see, let me know. I'm not doing a straw poll like Quill18 does. I don't have the patience to set one of those things up. I'm just kind of monitoring chat. Seeing more stuff about stock battles. So far, only a few votes cast. Now we have debts, more stock battles. Stock battles. Looking like stock battles is going to be a winner. All right, let's try this one out. You start with 5 of your own stock owned and 5 of your stock owned by a competitor. Your competitors all start with 4 stocks owned in themselves. Your stock is your lifeline, no matter how successful your business is. If your rivals are able to buy your company, you won't be able to be the one benefiting from your success. Once your opponents own your stock, however, there is no way to regain it short of buying them out. Fighting back from a disadvantageous stock position may be difficult and expensive, but will often be your best friend path to victory. Trying to pick off your other opponents is usually just delays the inevitable as your main opponent creeps up on the amount they need to buy out over time. Oh, this is going to be tough. This is going to be really tough. All right, let's give this one a shot. Let's see what the damage is. I don't know. Alright, so, yep, Mikhail is going to own a ton of my stock. Now, the good news is, right, because they started me off with some of my own stock, he will have to pay me twice the value of my stock price in order to buy me out. Now, to be fair, in order to get my stock back, I'm going to have to pay him double as well, but... this is going to be pretty tough. All right, this is a new game by the looks of it. So we're going to have to do our own start. Do we want to go for expansive, robotic, scientific, or scavenger? There's an absolute metric ton of iron and aluminum on the map. Fair bit of silicon. Here's the carbon. Wow, this is a very uneven map. All the resources are concentrated in just a few areas. All right, what do you guys think? Seeing this much iron and aluminum relatively close by, I'm thinking that going for either expansive or scientific could make some sense. Robotic could be good, but it depends a lot on what my opponents are making. If there are no other robotic, let's see. They haven't decided what they're playing as yet. Let's give them a second. No, we're not allowed to. We have to place RHQ. All right, we're not allowed to find out what they're going to do. I like going for robotic if nobody else goes for robotic, because that means that they're going to be consuming. Never mind. It looks like they are going to go for it. Okay. So the advantage of robotic is that you don't really consume food, oxygen, or water over time. You really consume a lot of power and a lot of electronics. So while everyone else is fighting for incredibly high water, food, and oxygen powers, you can move on to something else. It seems like people want to see science, though. Yeah, everyone wants to see science. All right, well, if we do that, this uses up aluminum, steel, and glass, just like expansive. We have less claims than expansive, but we acquire patents very rapidly. And if we build production buildings over, say, iron... So, okay, if you don't know, I'm assuming there are some new people who are involved here in Offworld Trading Company. The advantage of scientific is if we place this and then we build, let's say, a steel mill on the iron, we don't need to build any iron mines. So we can be more efficient with how we use our claims in the first place. That's one of the nice advantages to using that. I don't want to build over here because the aluminum's too far away. We could build something over here, and this would be rather risky, but it'd be interesting, wouldn't it? Because we could place a lot of glass kilns, electronics factories and stuff on the silicon. We could place steel on the iron. We have a little bit of aluminum nearby. Water relatively nearby. It's not an amazing starting point, but it could be interesting. And a lot of flat land, too. Science spot has not always been already been taken. You can build more scientific and stuff. That's fine. Let's try scientific. Look, if we lose, we can always try something else, right? So we're going to try scientific, and I'm thinking... I mean, this isn't a very good spot, right? This is a really good spot. So if I had gotten to that first, it would have been fine. I think we want to go for a scientific right over here. And it's a weird spot, but my gut tells me it might just work. So, we need to get some steel. We need aluminum. Glass, we start off with enough to upgrade to level 2. So first things first, let's get a metal mine on the aluminum here. Let's get a steel mine right here and sell off our carbon, our silicon, and place another one right here. All right, we're going to be consuming as much iron as possible, turn it into some steel, get some aluminum, or aluminium, if you're not American and you want to be like that. The colony has warehouses and habitats again, so just like last time, lots of food, water, oxygen consumed, lots of glass consumed. But we just care about getting enough resources to upgrade to level 2 as quickly as possible. That's the only thing that matters right now. I'm not going to sell off my steel, I'm not going to sell off my aluminum, I'm not going to sell off my glass.
A robotics HQ has been
upgraded. You already upgraded? Holy crap, that was fast. Is this game turn-based or something else? It is real-time strategy. Of course, I can pause, but that's all it is. It's not turn-based at all. There are no end turn buttons. It's not like Civ 6 or something like that. Think more like EU4, Age of Empires, stuff like that. But because we're not in a multiplayer setting, I can afford to pause as much as I need to make smart decisions, hopefully. All right, this is going to be enough, I hope. There we go. Upgrade. All right, 3 more claims. Price of water and food is going up. That's to be expected. No one's producing it right now. I would like to get some more water, and this makes sense placing it here. I don't expect the price of silicon or carbon to go up anytime soon. I think going for some food can make sense.
HQ has been upgraded.
And we can place food on the water. Wait a minute. I'm scientific. God, I don't need to place water. I can just place the things on the water. Damn it. All right.
Scientific HQ has been upgraded.
All right. I was just being a bit of a dummy there. I was testing you to see if you would notice. Let's produce some more resources. I need to get these claims going. All right, we have to sell this stuff off. Let's get some farms going. Place one here. Place one here for the adjacency bonus. That hurts. That was stupid. All right. Am I a Zelda fan? It's not really related to the game, but I used to be, and then it kind of fell off my radar for a long time. I found Zelda, and honestly a lot of Nintendo games, to be very formulaic. It's kind of did the same stuff over and over again in just a different setting. I was like, that's kind of boring. But the latest game looks rather impressive. I was a really big Zelda fan when I was a kid, just not so much when I became an adult. The A Link to the Past was my initial game. That's the one that I had the most fun with. And honestly, I still love that game. I would buy it in a heartbeat. Look at the price of fuel. Holy crap. Okay, price of water's gone down. I regret this water pump. Get rid of it. Get an electrolysis reactor instead. Sorry, that was funny seeing you slap yourself awake. Yeah, well, I deserved it. I deserve it. I'm a big dum-dum.
Scientific HQ has been upgraded.
We are still not getting enough money here. Extra claims? Of course I'm going to bid on that. Would love to get it. I'm a bit higher. I have a ton of debt, but I have to go for it. I'd actually like to get some power and get a geothermal plant. 16,000 though? No, 18th. I can't justify that. That's too much. Can't do it. Teleportation as soon as you get... Patron. You mean patent lab?
So
yeah. Teleportation would be really solid right now. Really good. Okay, why am I not getting any food here? This is weird. I'm producing 1.2 food per second, but it says I'm not... getting anything off of this. I have no quantity. Does my wife know she's married to a dum-dum? Oh my gosh, yes she does. Bless her heart. She knows she married the biggest dum-dum of them all. We still can't buy any more claims, can we? Gosh dang, that sucks. Alright, there's my food coming in. Thank you. Just had to wait for the shipments to arrive. Alright, we got some cash. Upgrade. 4 more claims. Electrolysis is still really good, but unfortunately we don't have a lot more patches of water. I'm kind of regretting my placement now. I haven't played scientific in a long time. Power would be really good. I need 7,900 to get that, though. Is there another geothermal vent? Or did you guys take them all? I think they took them all. I don't think there are any geothermal vents left. Nope. Resources. Nope, they've all been taken. All right, solar panel. 1.1. Why can't we do wind turbine? Apparently it costs too much to do. Well, I don't want to build solar panels in a little line like this because you can't do a lot of adjacency bonus. It's much better to place them in a place like this down over here. Let's get some power going. That's worth a lot of money. Yeah, I really need to get some patent labs going. But I just don't have any money to speak of. Holy crap. What else should we be getting, guys? What do you think? Silicon and carbon are worth a lot right now. We could just mine those and not refine them into anything. The alternative is to start building up some electronics. Supposedly there's a lot of money to be made in that. If we're scientific, we could do it. Of course, I don't really like that your quarry is here in the middle of the way. Is there any more carbon somewhere? No. Carbon's all in this crater.
Electronics would be really risky. Very risky. There is certainly more electrolysis, though. Because of the amount of water we have here, that's not much of an adjacency bonus. But we'll go ahead and do at least one more. And we could go for more food if we really thought that was a good idea. I see some people saying electronics. I think that electronics could work, but I think it may be too risky. I think we need to go for more food right here. And because of the placement of the water, it's not very efficient, but it's something we could do. Good news is the price of water is practically nothing, so if we had to, we could place more, but HQ has been upgraded. It's not amazing. It's just not. All right, we still need more aluminum, steel, and glass. Now, we don't have any glass production. Oh, gosh, the debt is so bad. Ah. I don't like it. All right, sell off that. Do we want to go for the patent lab? I think we have to go for a patent lab. Place. I would love to get that teleportation if we can afford it while the price of chemicals is still relatively low. That'd be helpful. One thing that would be really interesting is if I did go for carbon scrubbers, basically that means that anything that consumes carbon will automatically get it from the air. We don't have to be mining up any more carbon. So if we place electronics factories on, let's say, all this silicon over here, it would use up the silicon underneath it, it would use up the carbon from the air, the only thing we would need is aluminum, and we can get very cheap electronics. That could be really powerful. I still want to get teleportation because the price of fuel is incredibly high, but that could be super duper strong. Super duper strong. The resolution is trash. It's good on my end. So I don't know. Maybe your internet, or maybe it is me. Maybe it's my fault. I don't know. Patent lab. Teleportation's too expensive right now. Financial instruments, who has a ton of debt? 30k, no debt, bit of debt. Energy vault, superconductor. Well, I haven't put anything up against my HQ, so that's worthless. Water engine would certainly save me a lot of money in the short term. It would be better than using fuel, because water's cheap. But I really think teleportation's better, because then we don't need any fuel either. Problem is, the price is so high. Let's do it. Let's go for the teleportation. I said we wanted to do it, we're gonna do it. Carbon scrubbing could be so very strong. Yes, the other AIs do have other debts, so we can look here. It's kind of right down here if you can find it. It's kind of hard to show you, but Rennie, for example, has $62,000 in debt. Manuel has practically nothing. Mikhail has 33, and I have 66 as well. We have so much debt. But debt in the early game can be your friend, so you can expand fast. Slant drilling, I honestly don't usually like slant drilling. I don't find it to be that useful. I'll bid on it just to kind of drive the price up a little bit, but I don't actually have a lot of use for it. Now, the good news is we're going to get our patents very quick because we are scientific. So this might work out well for me. How are we doing as far as aluminum? Pretty close to being capped out on the aluminum. The glass is something I want, and the price is still going up. Congratulations. All right, Manuel, congratulations. You got your slant drilling. Jerk. Sell off some of that fuel. Okay, I don't have any more claims. I could buy something, but I'm not sure we care about this in the early game. I know a lot of people are tempted to go for the black market and to use these things, but the price goes up every time you use it. In the early game, there's not as much to screw over. I find it's usually better to wait until the late game to use the black market, with the exception of a goon squad for something really important, like my patent lab. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Just so they can't shut it down. Claims, of course, are great, but we don't have those yet. I like nanotechnology. I think carbon scrubbing could be incredibly powerful. I think it really could. Carbon scrubbing. And here's the other reason it's going to be really good. All right, once we finish this, we'll start working on it. The other reason it's going to be really good is not only can we get really cheap electronics and tons of profit, but the same thing is true with chemicals. And because of teleportation, our electrolysis reactors are going to be producing fuel that we don't use. So basically, we can use our surplus of fuel and free carbon to get really cheap chemicals too. Could be good. Could be really good. I still think teleportation is going to be great. There we go. All right, we're researching carbon scrubbing. Actually, you know what? Maybe we don't want to do this now. I'm seeing some people saying financial instruments could be better in the short term, and maybe that's true. Just so we can get the extra influx of cash. You know what? All right, let's go for financial instruments instead. I think you're right. I think you're right. How are we doing as far as resources? We have enough aluminum. We need more steel. And we need more glass. We can sell off some of the extra aluminum, but it's not worth a lot. Carbon, food, upgrade. All right, more claims are ours. Is there another geothermal plant? No, there's not. I didn't think so, but I saw this thing go up. A dust storm. Solar panel production goes down. Wind turbines are really good. Greenhouse farm. Solar condensers. Ah, gosh, dang. So what we could do, knowing that this is going to be true, is we could demolish our solar panel, because this is going to be here in a minute, and replace it with a wind turbine, at least temporarily, to start paying off some debt. Go ahead and scrap it. Let's do it. It's not going to use up any claims. Let's just make sure we can get a bit more. All right, so we have our claims going here. We still need more water, surprisingly, because we're consuming a bunch of it. Price of water is going up a little. If I were to build some water, let's say over here, we could fix that problem. There's a level 3 over here. Alright, we're going to place one there to future-proof, make sure we don't have any water problems. I'm going to go ahead and build some more power. Oh gosh, the power here is just atrocious for wind. I'm going to build another wind turbine here to get the efficiency bonus in anticipation of the dust storm, but eventually I'm going to want to demolish both of these and replace them with a solar panel. Don't let me forget, guys. Do not let me forget. Glass kilns are incredibly profitable, even though we do not have any silicon production. Do I want to build two glass kilns on the silicon? And I can always replace them later if I want to. Yes. Place. Place. We're going to go for that glass, make it cheaper to upgrade. Yes, I know, the debt is terrible. The debt is absolutely terrible. As soon as we get financial instruments, I'm going to go for the carbon scrubbing. I think that's going to make our profit margins for chemicals and electronics outrageously good. Because we're scientific, we can do things like that.
Black market is open for business.
Black market's open, don't care. Oh, God, our debt! Piling on so much debt! And the problem with debt, of course, is that they're going to be able to buy us out much easier. It should give us some warning, and I don't think they're going to be interested in doing that until they're about level 5, but... Water engine has been acquired, alright. As long as it's not carbon scrubbing. Mikhail built a patent lab. There's our financial instruments. So hopefully every night we're going to get a pretty good amount of extra money from their debt. Let's go for the carbon scrubbing next. I'm really playing late game here. I'm really planning on this stuff working out well for me. There's a dust storm. All right, start producing that beautiful, beautiful power. It's not enough to like get me any money, but at least I'm not going into more debt. Still worth it. Sell off the glass. So right now, oh my gosh, look at the profit margins on that sucker. Of course, he used an EMP recently, but... Oof! Is there anything else we want to screw over for them? I'd like to drive some prices up. Price of power, your patent lab, EMP, shut down his patent lab. Let's make sure that he doesn't get any carbon scrubbing. Energy vault has been acquired. I don't even think the energy vault is that good, so alright. Stop slowing my things down! They slowed down my patent lab. Or did they not? I don't know. It's changing how much time it has left.
We have a hard to come by land claim.
Yes, yes, please. Land is good. Oh my gosh, so much debt, but they're going to give it to me. Ah, no, they're not going to give it to me. Do I still go for it? Ah. No, I'm not going to go for it. I can't afford more debt because they're so close to buying me out. Any more debt could be the end of me. I can't afford it. Can't afford it. Can't afford it. Still need more aluminum, steel, and glass.
Let this be a lesson to you all. Screw with us.
Cold fusion has been acquired, so somebody doesn't require power anymore. Oh, you did a slowdown on my wind turbines. Now I'm not getting much of anything. Ah, that sucks so bad. All right. So we did finish that. We got our carbon scrubbing. Anything else we want? Perpetual motion reduces power consumption a lot. That could save me so much money. Look, we are scientific, all right? Our entire playstyle is getting a lot of extra bonuses so we can just outmaneuver our competition. We have carbon scrubbing. What should I do with it? Should we get chemicals? Yes, we should get chemicals. I don't have any claims, but we should get chemicals. Yeah,
The black market is online.
Price of fuel and oxygen is pretty low. I could actually justify getting rid of the electrolysis reactors temporarily so we can get something else that's more profitable. They're still pretty profitable, don't get me wrong.
Pirates.
Loot is better. Alright, well, the storm is over, so I think we should go ahead and get rid of these wind turbines, yeah? Let's get solar panels instead. That's gonna be better. We're gonna reduce our consumption of power. Hopefully that saves me from a ton of debt. Electronics will be very good soon. Very, very good. Alright, we have our perpetual motion. I love to get nanotechnology. I know I'm gonna be scrapping things a lot. It's part of my playstyle. This would save me a ton of money. But right now, not as important. Demolish this, replace with another solar panel, get that power going. Alright, doing great on food. Electronics are gonna be super freaking profitable right now. So is glass, though. Glass is remarkably good. I can sell off a bit of this. Upgrade. Okay. Electronics time. One. Oh, I don't have any more money. Hang on. Sell. Two. Sell. I think I want to go for more electronics, to be honest. Three. I'm really counting on these being profitable, but I think they will be. Nanotechnology would be so good. All right. I got, like, no interest on debt at all. Have you guys paid off all your debt? No, Rennie still has 92,000. It's just that was practically nothing. Financial instruments. I seem to remember you being a lot better than that, but okay. Would love to get the chemical refinery. I get a lot of really cheap fuel right now, and I get free carbon. So let's get ourselves a refinery. Now, there's no point in placing it on anything in particular because I already get free carbon. And you can't get fuel, so let's build one of these out. Start getting some money. I know, the debt is really bad. I know! Stop stressing me out! Everyone's, like, upset about the debt. I get it, the debt is really bad, but we need to build things so we can make enough money to pay off the debt! Alright, get these electronics factories, come on. All right, there's electronics. Net profit, 123. It still says glass is better. Free carbon, free silicon. We're doing okay on aluminum. We'll go ahead and stock that up for a rainy day. Solar panels are being done. There we go. All right. Making money on power now. That will automatically go to start paying off my debt. Good. Sell. Save the chemicals. Nanotechnology, I think we want. Go for it. That way, if the market changes, I can for free start shifting around electronics and glass and stuff, whatever I'm gonna need. Gotta spend money to make money, absolutely. I know, I got $1 from one of those guys in their debt. Selfish jerk. It's like he learned that credit cards are bad. Oh, I don't know. All right, I'm just gonna sell all that stuff off for now. Then we can start buying shares in other people if we wanted to. I'm more concerned about buying some of my own stock, but... Now, one thing we could do... We could cook the books. The banking regulators will use your contribution to fraudulently improve your bond rating regardless of your prior credit history. Yeah. Better bond rating at 148. That's actually a worthwhile use of money, I think. Cook the books. We're gonna try to reduce how much money we are spending every night when our debt comes due. Make sure we're auto-supplying, but I don't think we should have to do that.
Pirates.
I hate those filthy bandits.
Alright. So we're already level 5, which means I don't have to save up any more materials. Now, steel is still really profitable, which is why I'm going to keep these things going.
You shouldn't buy this and use it on
a power surge. I'll bid on it, but I don't anticipate I'm going to get it. Someone else is going to get it. It's not going to tell me who, of course. We have our nanotechnology. Virtual reality serves nothing for me. Sabotage? Eh. Honestly, I don't think we need anything else here right now, so I'm going to get rid of my patent lab. And I'd like to save up for an off-world market. Scrap it.
Sell.
How much do I need? $151,000? I should save my electronics, shouldn't I?
Yeah.
Alright, right now glass is still more profitable than electronics. I could get rid of this and start getting more electronic glass instead. Should I do that? You're lucky Mars doesn't have debt collectors. Oh, they totally do. Yeah, the AIs probably have been using Cook the books a lot, so that's probably is why their interest is so low.
Congratulations.
That probably is actually exactly what's going on. Back from KFC, prices are up on the meals. I blame Pravus for manipulating the market. That sounds like something I would do. Although I personally don't go to KFC. I prefer Chick-fil-A. All the way. Alright, glass is more profitable. We have the nanotech. We can do this for free. Let's just reset. We're not going to do any electronics right now. Go for the glass. We can afford to get a ton of profit by doing that. Not a lot of money to be had at electrolysis and food right now, but we'll keep it. It's good to diversify your markets a little bit, right? Sell that. I still want the off-world market. And as we get more electronics, that's going to get cheaper as time goes on. I shouldn't be selling my glass and steel either, actually, now that I think about it. All right, fine. We'll just sell chemicals. Aluminum we'll save for a rainy day in case the price ever goes up. Offload on some food. There's the off-world market place. All right. Oh, God! The colony's on fire! It's terrifying. Solar flare. Hey, that's great for my solar condensers, if only it weren't nighttime. But you'll notice our debt's starting to go down at least a little bit. All right. Glass is doing well here. Sell. I actually could have saved one electronics just so I could get a better price comparison, but it wouldn't take into account the efficiency. I do think going for that carbon scrubbing was a really good idea. I need to pay off some of this debt. Why am I selling my aluminum? I'm an idiot. Stop it. Stop being a dummy. Okay. So what do you guys think? Would it be smarter for me to buy my own shares of stock, pay off debt, or buy someone else? I'm thinking paying off my debt so my share prices goes up. Would be smart. Yeah, I think that would be good. I am relatively glad that we decided to dump and get a ton of... Oh, look at the glass prices go down, though. We have a surplus. Ooh, that's unfortunate. All right, these are not going to be as profitable anymore. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of some of these. And switch over to electronics again. Do you want to get more or keep some of the glass to be safe? I'll save one glass kiln, but let's go to more of the electronics because the price has gone down a lot. And it's going to get worse because I'm offloading my money. So there we go. Okay. Food still sells. Off-world market. Silicon is worth a lot. Fuel is worth a lot. Food is worth the most. Water. Sell water. We have a goon squad already. And we can rapidly change things around. Start making some money on electronics. Because I think we're going to get a heck of a lot more profit from that. Prices of glass has gone way down. Yeah, I think we pay off some debt. I'm just going to pay it all off. Screw it. We'll be fine. I'm too impatient to play any other way. At least it's down. Virtual reality acquired. All right. Share price is starting to go up a little bit, but we're doing pretty badly right now. I could buy an EMP to try screwing somebody over. A network virus could be good. Dynamite. Goon squads. Pirates. If we place pirates, what would we get? Fair bit of stuff if we did it, like, right here. Price of carbon's still low, so don't care about that. Actually, I already bought the filthy pirates. I just wanted to see what would be profitable to use it on, but apparently we have to do this. Could do this. This would be effective. Yeah. All right, let's screw over Rennie. Let's steal all this food. Food is profitable. Pleasure Dome. Bid. What difficulty am I on? There is no difficulty to set, as far as I'm aware. This is the Blue Chip Ventures DLC. It is challenge mode. It is set up for you regardless. I don't have as much use for that Pleasure Dome because I didn't get virtual reality. I'm going to let them take on the debt. All right, so electronics. Oh, yeah, look at that profit. Look at that profit. Ooh, it's so good. Ooh, it's sexy. I love it. All right. Sell off some of that. Price of iron has skyrocketed. Sold. So it actually would be probably more profitable for us to actually switch the steel mill over to iron because right now our iron consumes Our steel mill consumes one iron each. This could produce iron instead. I think it actually is more profitable to go ahead and delete these and get the iron mines until the market stabilizes, and then later I can switch back to steel. Look at that profit. Look at the profit. Oh, it's good. So good. Okay. Looking through the chat, not seeing anything too crazy there. Okay, we sold some water. We could sell some food. We wouldn't even have to purchase much. Yeah, let's go ahead and sell off our food. Slow down on Rennie. No one is trying to screw over my off-world market right now, which I'm very much appreciative of, but chemicals is not making me a lot of money right now. Well, that's distressing. Partly because the cost of fuel is so darn high. Interesting. Electrolysis stuff is now very, very strong. It's a little bit stronger than the greenhouse, but not by much. I can at least get rid of this one and replace it. Just to kind of get the best efficiency bonus possible, but it's not much. Of course, now the prices are going down. Price of steel is skyrocketing. Oh, look at the iron. What the heck? I just did this. Fine. I literally just did that. That's really frustrating, but okay. More steel. Switch back. Switch back. Won't take long. Yeah, look at the price of things changing so rapidly right now.
The black market is online.
Buying shares in himself. I need to keep paying off debt. It's almost midnight, and when that comes, I want to sell off my debt just beforehand. So in about now, pay it all off. Well, I'm sorry. There we go. All right, we got a little bit of money, but we at least didn't accrue quite as much interest. Only 1,000 this time. Good, starting to sell, get ourselves in a pretty decent position. Now, the one cool thing is we're actually not consuming anything, so everything is just raw profit right now. We did get a free EMP. Now, who should we use it on? Mikhail is our biggest threat right now because he's bought a lot of our stuff. This guy is so tightly packed, though. I could really mess him up. Mikhail, what else do you have that I care about? Electronics and stuff? Yeah. If I place the EMP, like, right here, I could shut down most of his core industry. Place it here would do the same thing. It's just a question of whether or not... Well, I could do this. There's a lot of stuff over here, though. Look how much stuff I could hit. I'd drive the price of steel and water way up. But Mikhail is by a long shot my biggest threat. Let's do this. EMP! Look at all the money. Alright, fuel's the big one right now. So let's go ahead and sell off some fuel next. Yeah, I like the fact that we're not really consuming anything except for power. We can finally pay off all our debt, so that's going to be done. Doop, 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 doop. All right. All right. So, I'm not going to buy any shares in myself. We're just going to live on the edge for a little bit. Let's start buying some shares in, let's say, Mikhail. And the reason is, nobody else has bought these shares, so I don't have to pay twice the price for it. I can afford to get some of these, and I'm going to have to buy Mikhail out in order to get my shares back. So let's try it. See how this works. Who got caught? No, I don't care about that. We need another goon squad on our off-world market. Let's do that. Perfect timing. All right, now we got a free dynamite. I still want to screw over Mikhail more than anyone else, but what do I use the dynamite on? I have a pleasure dome. I could screw over the geothermal, drive the price of power up. However, there is an off-world market. However, if I use it, odds are pretty good I'm going to hit a goon squad. But that might be worth it. I mean, off-world markets are your prime targets. It's not like anyone has patent labs and stuff. Although someone does have a hacker array, which is just rude. I say we blow up the off-world market. Yay! It goes exploded. Okay. So, price of electronics is by a long shot the most profitable. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the glass. Price of that has gone down a lot. Silicon's still quite low. Electronics is where we're making our money. That's where it's at right now. We're making very little profit on the chemical refineries. Is there something better I could replace this with? We could replace it with some more steel mills, I suppose. You know what? In hindsight, I should have put these refineries over here just so I would be able to do that if I needed to. Price of iron's still really quite cheap. Alternatively, more electrolysis. Even though I can't put it on water. What do you guys think? You guys think I should place... should I get rid of the chemical refineries and get something else? Could be better. Yeah, I know. That off-world market, shockingly enough, didn't have a goon squad defending it. The AI is a dummy, apparently. Keep buying shares in Mikhail. You bought my shares, I'll buy your shares. Let's have some fun. I now have the highest share price, which is great.
Successful off-world shipment.
Off-world shipment is done. Next, I think we sell off some fuel. Which is going to spike the price a little bit, but it's all right. We are completely self-sustaining. Everything we are doing is making us money. You don't have to worry about running out of anything right now. Replace it with a factory that prints money. Oh, hearty har har. Aren't you a clever boy? Well, at least the price of chemicals is starting to go up, so maybe we should just stick with this.
The black
market. Yeah, push and pain, you're right. It is spiking shortly. I'm curious, how are you predicting that? Because you've been right twice now, at least, that I've watched. So how are you predicting that so well? Very curious to know. Need 89,000 to buy more off of Mikhail. You know what we could do, actually? We could get rid of something and replace it with another off-world market. That'd be good. So when they buy your shares, do you get that money or is it just that they spent the money? No, I do not get the money. Do I? Actually, I might. I think you do. The computer buys what they need, which raises the price, and when they don't, they dump the price. So really, you're just watching the price of chemicals crash, and you're saying, all right, so pretty soon, the price is going to spike. Which makes some sense. I mean, to an extent, that is exactly how the market works. And we're getting a little bit of money off of debt. All right, we're going to keep trying to buy out Mikhail. I need $449,000. steel is not very profitable right now, so I'm going to go ahead and demolish this, and we're going to save up for another off-world market. I think that would be smart, right? Off-world markets are good. Another dust storm is coming. Oh, no! Fuel's still the most profitable, huh? All right, fuel it is. We have about a minute before the dust storm arrives. Why the time keeps shifting like that? I don't know. There's 53 again. It keeps shifting. It's like it doesn't know what it's doing. Off-world market. Place. I don't need to cook the books. Network virus takes control of a building so it can't be turned off, cannot be scrapped, and will automatically buy input resources. Which is good if you want to screw over people into buying stuff. So, for example, if I use a network virus here, I think this is going to force Mikhail to buy water for food that is no longer profitable, or won't be for very long. Virus. Yeah, that should screw him. All right. I actually do like playing scientific. I've kind of forgotten how good it is, but it's pretty good. So do we want to switch over to wind turbines again? It wasn't a lot of power last time, but it could be something. I mean, these solar panels are about to become worthless. We have nanotechnology. We can do it for cheap. Let's just go ahead and do it. Just go ahead and do it for now. We'll switch it back later. Electronics is still very profitable. Aluminum. All right, so they EMP'd that. The price is going up. We're consuming a fair bit here, but we'll be okay. Wow, where did we get all this silicon? I don't remember having this. Well, the price is still going up. I guess I'm going to hold on to it. Mikhail's a scientist, so the network virus doesn't actually hurt him. God, you're right. You're right. I forgot. You want me to slap myself again? All right. Ow. Yeah, I understand that by selling stuff off, I'm part of the problem of why the prices are dropping and stuff. I'm aware. I think it looks like food is by a long shot the most profitable right now, so let's go ahead and launch that. We'll cue that up because this one's about to be done.
Launch affirmative.
There you go.
What a payout.
Look at those electronics go. It's so good. We could buy another goon squad. Do we care about that, or do you want to save up some money to buy people out? Okay, price of chemicals is starting to go down. Let's go ahead and sell that before the price goes any further down. Price of silicon did not go up any further. I can crash the market price. Do we have any other use for the silicon? I don't think so. Sell. Buy some shares in you, but I don't care about that. The price of food... Why? I'm apparently not producing enough food anymore. Okay. Seems fair. Why? Why am I consuming more food now? Oh. Well, no. I'm not sure, actually. It was in the green before. I don't think I've changed anything there. food is... Nope. Sorry. Water's the most profitable. Let's go ahead and sell that off. Where am I making water again? Right, this water pump here. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of you. Price of water's gone way down. Let's get some more food. Oh, I'm producing less food because of the dust storm. You're right. The dust storm does reduce that. Speaking of which, dust storm's over. Let's go ahead and switch off the wind turbines. Get that back. Off-world markets. More water? Sure, more water. Price of food's starting to go down. Figures. Price of oxygen and fuel is really high. Okay, price of food's about to plummet, which is unfortunate because I just switched things around, but... It's alright. Still need 484,000. I don't know what happens as far as when I buy him out, what happens with the rest of my shares here. I don't think it technically matters. Although, wait a minute. I just had a thought. So, if someone else buys you out, the only way you get out of that, right, is if you buy them out. If I buy him out and he gets a ton of money, will he have enough money to then buy me out and then I'm screwed and we'll just kind of have to go back and forth? Glass prices are going back up. Is it enough to justify switching off electronics? Possibly. Let's delete one and see what happens. It should pay off his debt, but it's no point in doing it until the end of the day. Ooh, wow. What happened to the price of steel there? Boom! And then right back up. Where are we getting this carbon? I like it. Aluminum's doing fine. Fuel. Sort of bring some prices down a little bit. Not producing a lot of water, but that's fine. The price is going to start going up because we're not consuming or consuming more than we're producing. Looks like we just want to keep selling off water, which unfortunately is going to start raising the price up even more because we're buying a bunch, but that's fine. Yeah, it looks to me like glass is going to start getting more profitable here pretty soon. If the price of electronics keeps going down, which it will if I keep selling stuff off. Let's switch one more over to glass for now. Get some efficiency bonuses at the very least. We'll keep it diversified for the time being. Wow, prices are really high in this game. Really high. Kind of crazy. So. No, he can buy you out. Yeah, he can buy me out. You buy him out, he buys you out, and you just trade companies. Basically, that's exactly what would happen. No, if I buy him out, I don't think he's out of the game. It will be incredibly pricey to do that. But he already has half of my shares. That's sort of the problem. As long as my share price is higher than his, maybe we're okay. Maybe. Oh yeah, look at the price of glass. Alright, time to tech switch. Tech switch over to glass. My wife is peeking in the door. Are you okay? Oh, she's just saying hi. Hi. Alright, about to finish off a couple more off-world markets. I'll be able to buy him out now. Do we try it? Look at all the money. When you buy Mikhail out, he's out of the game and you gain control of all the shares he owns. Do I own his Do I? I guess it's true. I could show you guys what would happen. For science, right? Oh, praise science. I shall sacrifice myself for you. Go ahead and get more food going. You know what? Let's try it. Buy him out. Oh, no, I get all the shares. Okay, I did not know that worked. All right, we now own all of our shares. We own him. No one's buying me out anytime soon. We are powerful now. Oh, that's good. All right, we have a couple more claims. Let's get some more steel mills going, because there's a ton of profit to be made there. Actually, iron's pretty high, too. What else would be really solid? Glass is still quite good. Steel is okay. Look at the electrolysis. Holy cram. Ooh. I could justify a tech switch. I could justify buying water. Then again, I don't have to get rid of the greenhouse farm. I could use a claim. Place one right here. We'll have to buy water out, but I think it's worth it. Do it. Do it! Sell some stuff off. Buy some shares of Manuel. I've received $67 from Manuel. Financial Instruments is worthless to me. I'm not even sure if it's paid for itself in this game. Oh, we should have paid off our debt. I forgot about it. Oh well. People are still shipping things off world.
Pirates. I hate those filthy bandits.
Doop a doop 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 doop. Price of water skyrocketing. Alright, get rid of this again. Get a water pump. We have teleportation, so fuel is not the concern. Who are we going to focus on next? Do we want to focus on Rennie, because he's an easy target, or do we want to focus on Manuel? I could screw you over pretty good right now if I use an EMP, and I'm going to. Bam! Say goodbye to your off-world market. I know he has a goon squad on it. That's to be expected. $110,000 here right now. Pravus's evil laugh is amazing. Oh, you haven't heard my evil laugh. That was just a happy chuckle. looks like food is still a winner. Not by much, though. There we go. I'm not going to do my evil laugh for you right now, by the way. There's no point. Price of water is so high right now. Holy crap. Yeah, we have to buy water for this right now. It's going to keep going up, but... Net profit on electrolysis is ridiculously good. Solar, not so awesome. So glass is still okay. Steel's doing pretty good. Chemicals, not great. Chemicals are really expensive because of what? Fuel prices? Yeah. I guess that is a bit of a problem. People are saying we should buy out Rennie next. Probably, because he's the cheapest. Price of electronics is too low to be worth my time. Price of chemicals is kind of hovering right now. If I get rid of that, what should I do? You want to know what this... Okay. You want us to know what this poster says? There you go. And that's all you're getting. I'm not sure what I should replace the chemical refinery with. Now, it's only doing this because the cost of fuel is so high, but because the cost of fuel is so high... Holy God! Look at the frickin' water! Thank you for the donation! Glass will balance out when the computer can buy carbon and double the price and profit. Yes, thank you for the donation. Really appreciate that. Okay, okay. Freaking water. Holy crap. Delete. Delete. Water. Water. Forget frickin' food right now here. Whoa, 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 whoa! Look at that! Okay, I understand that sometimes prices go down and all that, but that was like a legit crash. Cancel construction, go back to the food. Did you see that? 300, boom! Down to 40-something. That's a little unpleasant. All right. Well, I'm gonna do then, if we don't really have any use for this chemical refineries, I think I actually agree with what I'm seeing here from Heptopus. Let's get ourselves a hacker array and an optimization center. At least temporarily to make ourselves more effective. Off-world markets, water's pretty good. We're gonna drive that price right back up if we do that, of course, but you know what, let's also launch some steel. Let's not crash the market again. Yeah, that water was nuts. Wow. So, yeah, Manuel brought out Remy, which means I need to start buying him out next. So we need to screw him over, right? We could do another EMP. He's producing a lot of water, but that's not worth the most. Electrolysis, however, would be worth a ton. This could be pretty good. Boom! Say goodbye, Manuel. Let's buy out some shares. I keep forgetting we need to pay off our debt because it's about to be night. There we go. And we have to pay practically no interest. We get $164 off of him. We're going to crash the price of glass if we're not careful here. But all right. Hacker arrays and stuff like that could be useful. Producing some food again. Good. Price of water is starting to skyrocket again. What the crap is happening with that? All right. Well, we're not... I guess I can drive down the price of... power if we wanted to, but we could also drive up the power of something, price of something else. And I say we drive up the price of glass. We have plenty of glass in reserve. Let's do that. So that's the hacker array. The optimization center, we can make something more effective. What should we do that with? If we overproduce too much on glass, it's going to hurt. We could improve our production of food or oxygen. Fuel would be okay, actually, but I think we should do food. Let's improve our food production. That way, we can produce more of it, because right now we're not getting much. Fuel is really quite high, but I can crash that market by selling a fair bit off. We have a surplus of that right now. Aluminum's doing really well. I want to hold on to my glass until the hacker array does its thing. Buy more shares, and we need $618,000 in order to buy out Manuel. Okay, so, honestly, the off-world markets have been very lackluster in this game. We're going to sell off some steel. And more steel? Let's drive up the price of silicon. Manuel, you are a expansive HQ, yeah? Yeah. I need to keep screwing with him right now. Okay, we're about to finish our optimization, which means we'll produce a fair bit more food. There we go. Not by much, but a little bit. We could also improve our production of... aluminum wouldn't be too bad. Oxygen could be pretty good. Price of water has crashed again. Glass would be tempting, but if I overproduce, I'm going to just crash the market for selling too much. I think I'm overproducing it right now. I think we could improve our oxygen a little bit. Or we could do more food. Let's do more food. We'll just make food even better. All right, how can we screw you over? We could EMP you again. Could network virus you. But what would I network him on? There's nothing that he'll be producing that's worse. What would I dynamite? I could dynamite one of his off-world companies. Pirates. A slowdown strike would be pretty good, actually. This cannot be stopped by the goon squad. He'll produce a heck of a lot less, and he'll launch less shipments. And this way, I'm not risking losing my dynamite to a goon squad. I say we do a slowdown strike right here. That's going to slow down a lot of his main moneymakers. Still need a lot of money. Sell. Oh, we said we were going to hold on to that glass, didn't we? Shoot. Solar flare. All right, solar production's better than ever. Yay. All right, let's watch that price of glass go up pretty soon. What else do we want to hack? I think we should hack... I have a lot of fuel. We could... I think we just keep doing glass. Glass is what we have a lot of. Glass is what we're going to keep using it on. That's all that matters. We have no debt, which is awesome. We're gonna win this one. I am very certain. Ooh! Well, there goes my metal mine. Repair that sucker. He decided to dynamite something. And that's the off-world markets. Which, again, is very lackluster, but... the price of water is just giving me a headache. Look at that. Look at that. We're gonna ship off some oxygen. And some steel. I'm not going to mess with water right now. I'm very confused about my water. Very confused. But all right, the price of steel is still going up. I'm going to wait till it gets up to a cap. Is that about as good as it's going to get? That's about as it's going to get. All right. Sell, 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 sell. Ah, I thought we were going to have him. Ah! Bye. And that's the end of that. Ugh! Ooh, boy. Two blue chip ventures down. This is going better than I thought it would. I'm not going to lie. Ooh. Okay. So, what do y'all think of that? Yes, I know my food. I'm waiting for the chat to catch up because we just won. All right. Not bad. Not bad at all, everybody. Pretty good. What time is it right now? It is 4 o'clock. We've been streaming for about 2 hours. You guys want to keep going on this? Or should we change things up? We could keep playing Offworld Trading Company. We could try another one. That could be fun. The other options, what is there? We could... Well, what would I want to stream, though? I don't really want to stream CK2 right now. That might be a little bit too much of a pain. We could stream... Rimworld? What do you guys think? It sounds like people are saying we should go for a different game. I see Action Pack Dude saying go for Ceres. Now, I actually did a video on Ceres a while ago. Was it a skirmish or a campaign? Yeah, a new skirmish game on Ceres. I did a video on that. I don't think there's really anything to do there. Banished? I'm actually not going to stream that because I'm going to give you guys a little inside tip. Starting a Banished series this week with the Colonial Charter mod pack. Oxygen not included. Stellaris, not going to do Stellaris yet until the new expansion comes out. I am going to break this down into parts on YouTube. So you know what? It sounds like people want me to stop playing Offworld Trading Company. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take a break from this. We're going to end the recording for YouTube. So those of you who are watching on YouTube, thank you very much for sticking around. I hope that you enjoyed. This has just been kind of a casual stream, but at least we were able to get down a couple of those adventures. Blue Chip Ventures is pretty tough. There's no doubt about it. I imagine the further down you get to something where, like, all the AIs are ganged up on you, it's going to be really, really tough. But we are able to finish at least two of them pretty well. It's tough, but it's worth it. About an hour per scenario. So, hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to hit that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe if you have not already. And I, as always, will see you guys next time.